Hey there, VC. I'm Brian, this is Shamrock and Records. And today I'm doing a contest entry for Chris Profi's 413 subscribers contest. So first off, congratulations, Chris. Well deserved. Good job. You know, he's only been around for about a year, if that. And he's already hit over 400 subs. So, wow. That's quick. So congratulations, man. Basically, Chris would like us to show four records that are our favorites, one record that we bought on a whim, and the three represents three records that are essential to a particular genre. So today, one of my absolute favorite artists is Stephen Kellogg. And he is from like the Western Central Massachusetts area originally, which the area code is 413. So when Chris mentioned 413, I used to live in 413. So I lived in North Adams. I went to college in North Adams, Massachusetts, and Stephen Kellogg, I believe, originally is from the the Northampton area, I believe, and which is a 413. So this record is a live record. With Stephen Kellogg means a ton to me. He is one of my probably top five favorite artists. I listen to him constantly, and I feel like I don't talk about him enough on my channel. And he really deserves for me to talk about him. This was recorded on the year up to his 40th birthday, thus the tour to 40. He's a singer-songwriter that started off with a band. He called himself Stephen Kellogg and the Sixers. He then broke away from the Sixers. They kind of disbanded and he just did his own stuff. But he's somebody that, if you're into singer-songwriters like Josh Ritter, you should really check this guy out. His songs are very personable, or personal, I should say. His songs are very autobiographical. He married his high school sweetheart. He's got several girls. I think he has four kids, all girls. And he always writes a song for them. He just writes beautiful songs. Kind of in that poppy song. I don't want to say poppy, but John Mayer. You know, you can kind of put him into that kind of genre of singer-songwriters. But like I said, if you're into like Josh Ritter, Josh Ritter actually does work with Stephen Kellogg, so I highly recommend him. This is, I'm not going to say my favorite record by him, but I'm highlighting this record in particular because it has a lot of my favorite songs by him on it, and a lot of his early material was never recorded on vinyl. So that's why I'm showing this particular record. Another favorite artist of mine is the Gin Blossoms. You guys all know I love Toad the Wet Sprocket. Toad the Wet Sprocket and the Gin Blossoms always kind of went hand in hand for me. You know, this is a New Miserable Experience. This came out while I was in high school. And it's something that I just listened to throughout high school and college. It's, you know, when everybody was listening to, like, grunge, I was really more into the Gin Blossoms and Toad the Wet Sprocket and R.E.M. and more of that alternative kind of jangle pop kind of sound. Gin Blossoms have that jangly guitar sound. So, Gin Blossoms, you know, everybody knows, I can't think of it right now. Hey, Jealousy! Ah! That was their big hit. So, Gin Blossoms. Another record that is one of my absolute favorites that I really never show is American Beauty by the Grateful Dead. This is something, again, college. This is something I listen to in college all the time. Ripple is my most absolute favorite song by the Grateful Dead. It's on this record. But, I mean, Box of Rain, Friend of the Devil. This is a classic record that you all know. I don't have to discuss this at any length, but it's one of my favorite records. And if you're into, you know, folk and country, then this is essential. This is not my essential record, but it's essential. Another favorite artist, another favorite record is Guster's Goldfly. This is a Press on Gold vinyl. This was the first time this was on vinyl by Guster. But again, college. My college years are the years that I was really getting into my own music. High school and college. I mean, there's just so many memorable memories. Going to parties, meeting new people. This is the kind of stuff that I was listening to. When I was in college, I played my guitar all the time. I constantly have my guitar. I bring it to parties. I break it out at parties. The song on here called Demons is something that I played constantly. And it just means a lot to me. They had they don't even have a regular drummer. They had a conga player. And if you saw these guys live, he literally would tear up his hand. He'd have bloodied hands by the end of the show. And they would, you know, just be taped up, and just a great, great melodic, good harmonies. They kind of got into that jam band kind of thing. They formed in Boston and Tufts University, so they kind of always get tied in with the band Dispatch. I know people hate Dave Matthews in the VC. I like Dave Matthews, whatever. If you like Dave, this is that kind of jam band, melodic kind of stuff. Very organic, acoustic, the congas and stuff. It was really cool shit. So, Guster, Goldfly. Love it. Essential for me. Now, the one record I bought on a whim. I had never heard this prior to buying it. I heard people talk about it in the VC, and that's how I discovered this. And this is Steve Young, Rock, Salt, and Nails. Singer-songwriter. If you like Towns Van Zandt, this is that kind of sound. It's a very hard record to come by. So when I saw that, I saw this at a records show in Portland, Maine, at a good price, because the spines are all taped. Everyone is taped. But I've never seen this record, and I never saw it since I bought it. It's the only time I've seen this record. I bought it on a whim. I'm so glad I bought it on a whim, because it is incredible. It starts off with That's How Strong My Love Is. It's just a wonderful wonderful cover of that, but it's, you know, acoustic singer-songwriter stuff. You know, you like I said, Towns Van Zandt, John Prine, and you see this out in the wild, pick it up. it's incredible. All right, now, three records that I think are essential to specific genres. The first one I'm going to show is Jimmy Cliff's The Harder They Come, reggae. All right. This is essential for any reggae collection. I know a lot of people are going to say Bob Marley. Yes, Bob Marley's essential. This is just as essential as Bob Marley, if not more. I mean, this is one of the best reggae records that has ever come out. It is summery. It is fun. You know, if you're going down to the beach, you're driving your car on a hot summer day, this is the kind of stuff I want to listen to. This is the kind of stuff I would recommend listening to. It's essential for any reggae collection. If you're not a big reggae fan, and You know, this is something when I worked at Bull Moose and somebody would come in and they would recommend, or they would ask for a recommendation for a reggae record. This is something that I always recommended. Right here, Essential. The next genre I wanna talk about is country. And the record that I would recommend as an essential country record is Redheaded Stranger by Willie Nelson. This is absolutely gorgeous. It's my favorite Willie Nelson record. It's one of my favorite country records. It's pretty. It's melancholy. It's very... Storytelling's fantastic. But it's a very quiet record. It's very minimalistic, okay? If you're gonna buy this record, make sure you buy a clean copy of this record. This is the kind of record that if you buy something and it's got pops and skips and hisses, it's gonna annoy the crap out of you because it's just such a quiet record. I bought the cleanest copy I could ever find of this record. And you can get it rather cheap. I only paid $15 for a completely beautiful copy of this record. So, it's not going to break the bank. And it's one of the best things you're going to hear on a turntable. It is absolutely incredible. Now, the last genre that I chose was metal. And the record that I would say is essential is Black Sabbath's Paranoid. This is probably the first metal record I heard. You know, as a little boy, who knows, 2-3 years old, my parents would play this for me. My dad would play Iron Man for me. You know, my dad always tried to play things. When I was a little kid, I remember he would play this. He would play he would play Iron Man. He would play Superman by the Kinks. Anything that would like get me interested in music, you know. He would play what the hell is that Cheap Trick song? Your mom is all right, your daddy's all right, but they both seem a little weird. Yeah, Surrender by Cheap Trick. You know, the do 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 da 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 by the Police. Anything that would be like an earworm for a little kid is what my parents would play for me, and it really got me into music. And Iron Man was probably the very first metal song that I ever heard. This is an original German press. It's absolutely gorgeous. I showed this on my vinyl tag. And it's on Vertigo. It's minty, minty fresh, let me tell you. I've never seen such a clean copy. The guy that had this before me only played it like once or twice. He recorded it onto like a cassette or something, and that was it. And then it sat on a shelf. Anyway, those are my records, 4 favorites. One record I bought on a whim, and 3 records that I would highly recommend for a genre. Chris, congratulations on 413. I'm sure you're going to be at 500 by the end of this contest. So, congratulations again, and cheers.